AM. Informative. Insightful. Inspiring. And fun. On this episode of Conversations with Dr. Brenda, a conversation with Dr. Pamela Hadley. Now here's Dr. Brenda.
Well, hello, hello. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Conversations with Dr. Brenda Goodeau. I am so glad that you all are joining us today. And also we are welcoming my special guest, which is Dr. Pamela Hadley. We're so excited about her being a part of our conversations. I'm just so glad she's a part of our family, our newly joined marriage. I guess you might be a year now. I don't know. I don't know how long, but we're excited about having this conversation to get to know you more and just to let you share some of the great things that are happening in your life and just something about you. So you that are joining in, just join me as we conversate with Dr. Pamela Hadley. Hi, Pam.
Hi, Dr. Brenda.
All right. Well, we always start with asking you to tell us a little bit about yourself. And when I say little, I don't want you to just feel like you're in a box here. I want you to be able to tell us about who Dr. Pamela is and Let's hear what's going on in your life, how you became a doctor, and all that great stuff.
Amen. First, I want to thank you, Dr. Brenda, for giving me this opportunity to sit with you and have this conversation. I've been excited about this for a while. And as you know, we had some technical difficulties at the beginning, but, you know, God overcame. And so we're here today. So I'm thankful and grateful and privileged and honored to be here with you today. So thank
you.
Thank you. So just to tell you a little bit about myself, what I do, I have two businesses and a few products. The first business is called First in Flight, which is a destination for relaxation Airbnb suite. First in Flight is also a distributor of my herbal tea line called Tierra Teas. It's a luxury herbal tea line. The second business is called Hadley Consulting. We specialize in change management. And with Hadley Consulting, basically, my goal is to help individuals as well as people of churches, ministries, businesses navigate change to help them transition. A lot of times businesses that call on change management professionals to come in and help them, they usually focus on the business side of the ministry church organization. Well, my goal is to focus on the people and help them get through it because they're the most impacted by the change. Most of the time. So also under Hadley Consulting, I do some voiceovers and things of that nature, voice talent, as well as I have two books. I'm an author. Both books are available online at Amazon, Walmart, Barnes and Noble. So that's what I do.
That's awesome. That's great to know. You jump right into the business. We want to know also, because that is amazing, all the things that you're doing, all the places you have your hands. The Lord said he will bless what you put your hands to, and you've allowed him to bless you to be used in many areas. But we want to know a little bit about where you're from, where you were born, a little bit about your that. Got you to this point of all the entrepreneur opportunities that you're stepping into. What is that makeup? Okay.
Yes. Okay. So, well, I was actually born in Nevada, a small town. Hawthorne, Nevada is where I was raised. Born in Urington, Nevada. I don't know if anybody's heard of that, but it's a very small town in Nevada.
Heard of Hawthorne, not the other.
You've heard of Hawthorne, Nevada? Yeah. Okay. Yeah. There are two. There's one in California, Hawthorne, California, and there's a Hawthorne, Nevada. But I was raised there, well, up to the age of 10 and then moved here to Sacramento with my mother, who was a single parent. I later was married very early on at the age of 21, very early. And my ex-husband now, we have four 5 girls together. We were married for 25 years. And so I have a lot of experience in that area. Mm-hmm. You know, things just didn't work out. We got married very early. Mm-hmm. And so now I'm writing another book called First Lady Syndrome, because I was the minister's wife, pastor's wife, bishop's wife to the husband for 25 years. So that's a very, it was a very, a time in my life where I learned a whole lot about who I am in God and the direction that He wants me to take in my life. And, you know, a lot of times, and I wasn't expecting to go this route, but I'm just going to say this, and maybe it'll be a blessing to somebody out there. Because a lot of times when we as Christians find ourselves in divorce, we tend to hold on to a lot of shame as a result of that. But we have to understand that even that is covered under the blood of Jesus. Everything and anything, you know, is covered under the blood of Jesus. And we don't have to hold on to that shame anymore because it was nailed to the cross. And so that is another thing that I want to get into a little bit more, especially with First Lady Syndrome. And I have another book that I'm writing, which is called Convalescence of a Fractured Vessel. So I have a couple of book projects that I'm working on, but they are prophetic books, prophetic writings. And I say that because I believe the Lord gave me the titles and the content, a little bit of the content years ago, not knowing that I would be the fractured vessel in which He would be working on and helping to go through the healing process and coming on the other side of victory, not knowing that I would be the one talking about First Lady Syndrome and having a deeper understanding of what God is capable of doing in our lives as believers, as someone who never thought that I would find myself divorced after 25 years. But things happen, you know, but it doesn't mean that God has blotted you out of His book of life, because we are redeemed by the blood of the cross. Jesus, and He's just, He is more than able to bring us through any situation.
Amen. Wow. Wow. Well, I had no idea. Like you said, this is not exactly what you were planning to speak on, but it is so important, Dr. Pam. I mean, it's just really just to show, when you start sharing all that you've got, you know, put your hands to, and all that you're making a difference in your book writing and in all of your businesses and things, to show where you came from and that, you know, God's plan for you, nobody's going to get in the way of what, you know, what God has for you. And how much more can you help people? Because right now people need to know that there is victory on the other side of, of things that we don't plan them. But God knows how to, put us in a situation, allow us in certain situations. And when you keep your heart right, and obviously you kept your heart, you know, towards God, and so that God can bless you on the other side and to continually bring out. So you're saying that you started some of these writings before a lot of this took place, right? Prophetic?
Yes. I have 2 books out, as I mentioned before, Elegant Living on a Budget, which pretty much opened the door to other writings and brought a lot of exposure to what I do. Elegant Living on a Budget is the book that allowed me to get 2 awards for my writings. But I call them prophetic writings because there are books that, they're obviously not for everyone.
Sure.
But they're not for everyone. But when it's for you, you're going to know it. Mm-hmm. And communicate. The Lord gave me a gift, which is in the line of prophecy, prophetic gift. And what I did not realize was that writing can also be a prophetic avenue through which the Holy Spirit operates. Sure. Because prophecy, prophetic, being a prophet and operating in that gift, it's basically a mode of communication. It's communicating what God is giving you to give to the people. Mm-hmm. So whether you're speaking, I know some prophetic psalmists, but what I did not know was that God was going to use me in that area of prophecy through writing, the prophetic writing.
I think that's even greater, because when you hear the prophetic word, unless someone is there recording it or somebody's writing it down, it's like, I know God was speaking to me, but, you know, can I remember everything that he said, and can I go back and go over it? Some people do, you know, have the recorders out, and, you know, they can go back, because there's been so many prophecies that has been over my life and over the ministry and different things. And there's just a very few that actually say they can go back and pull it up and just be reminded about what God said and what God was doing. And just knowing that he was there all the time, and he was just preparing for our future, the things that he has for us. So I think that's excellent to put it into writing, that and know that it's God breathed, you know, it's the word of God, and it's what God's plan is. So I think that's excellent. And so you said the title kind of fast. So it's like elegant with a budget. Is that
Elegant Living on a Budget is my first book. It's a handbook. And then Relationship Dynamics, that's my second book, which is the first of many prophetic writings. The relationship, and then I'm working on a couple of other books. But the Relationship Dynamics, I say that's a prophetic book because it's a book that I actually had the title, and a piece of I knew the direction that the Lord would have me to take. But what I did not know at the time, now this was given to me years ago, what I did not know at the time years ago was that the book would be about me.
Wow.
And because I had not gone through what I have gone through now, therefore I didn't necessarily have the content to put into the book. In other words, I didn't have the end of the story until I had been through it.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Amen. And just the fact that the Lord has blessed you with five daughters, five girls. Amen. Relationships are so important. Relationships and just being able to navigate through life and just understanding there is, Pastor was just teaching this Sunday based on relationships and friendships and how, you know, we have different people that are in our lives for a purpose. They're there, and they can come so close. And so there's just different ways that, you know, getting the dynamics out of different relationships. And like you said, it's not possibly for everybody, just like our ministry is not for everybody. There's just different people, like you said. But when you are drawn to us, or when you're drawn to the book, or when you're drawn to our businesses, you know that's what you need.
Absolutely.
You know that this is sent by God for you. Absolutely. And for somebody to be able to pick up your book and just be able to just glean and be ministered to, I just think to have that written, I think that's great, you know. And
absolutely.
So, yeah. So, yeah, those it's things just, that we go through life, you know, you said, you know, you were married at an early age, and none of us know from day to day exactly what all we're going to face. But the scripture tells us that the steps of a good man or woman are ordered by the Lord, and some things we don't understand, we don't think it should be happening this way. But like you said, there's no condemnation to those who are in Christ, you know, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. And I'm just so glad coming from that, because there's many people that have been in church and been in ministry, and if things didn't go a certain way, they walked away from God. They've walked away from. But if you know your God, the scripture says you can be strong and you can do exploits. And that's what I see coming out of you. You're being strong, and he's doing mighty things, dynamic things through you as a woman of God. So it's just amazing. Amen. So how would you say that you got started in some of the different businesses and things on that line?
Well, I actually retired from the state of California. And when I, while I was working there, I was also earning my degrees.
Okay.
So during that time, and I was there for 20 years, I was working on my degrees. And so once I finally retired, I had already had 2 books and business ideas.
Okay.
And so, and the product ideas, like the teas and whatnot. I have some others coming down the pike as well. But when I retired, I believe the Lord was showing me, okay, because, you know, when you retired after working a long period of time, you know, of receiving a decent amount of income or salary, it's reduced significantly once you retire.
Okay.
And so, you know, you get a little concerned sometimes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so that was me. And when I retired, I prayed to the Lord and I thought, okay, Lord, what's the next steps? You know, and I believe the Lord was showing me, okay, well, what's in your hands? And right. So I said, okay, well, what I have in my hands are, I have the books, mm-hmm. you know, I have these ideas, I have education, and I have experience. So I'm going to take all these ideas and just work them, lay the foundation, and then cast my bread upon the waters and see what happens.
I love it.
I'm doing. So, but I would advise anyone who has multiple businesses or multiple business ideas to focus on one at a time, to lay the foundation, focus on one, lay the foundation, make sure it's set up well. I mean, I've done the trademarks, I've done the copyright, you know, the business licenses, the EIN number, set up the business account, all of that different stuff. Make sure it's a solid. And recently received my BBB, Better Business Bureau accreditation. So I just focused on one at a time, made the foundation, made sure it was a legitimate business that is can stand on its own, work out all the kinks, create a system, let it do its thing, move on to the next one and do the same thing. And then once they're all done, cast the bread upon the waters and see what to do.
Put it in God's hands. Yes.
It's diversification. It's diversification, you know, because you don't know which one is going to do so well and which one will not. So you just have multiple streams of income.
Right.
Ideas. So that's what I'm doing.
Yeah. Well, listening to you, it just gives me so excited because you are, you know, going to be a part of our women's business conference on Saturday. I just love it because your points and being focused on certain things and knowing that you do your part and then you give it to God, you know, and then that's what I really want to impart to women. And just the fact, now you're telling us how you're working and then you're still pursuing your degree and, you know, these thoughts are going through, but as a woman, you've got children.
Yeah.
You know, you're still raising a family, you know, and all these different things that a lot of women just like, I can't do anything because I got children, I've got this to do, and I got that to do. But for you to be able to continually doing those, that's God all by itself. For it's him to be able to help you, because we got to give our children to God. We do what we can do with them, but at the same time, they're very important. They're, I'm sure, during some very formative years that you know had them, but yet God can still do it if you got a mindset. You have a mind to be open, and there's more to you than just being a mom and just, you know, doing certain things and a wife. And so God has a plan, and so that's amazing to me. And I think women just need to hear it. So I just want to applaud you.
Thank you.
And say thank you for your writings, you know, because we never know whose hand the different things are going to go in from years, from generations to, you know, years from now and even now. the things that God has brought you through. And again, for me as a pastor's wife, you know, I know that there are many challenges in ministry, and I know how the devil don't want us to make it, you know.
Yeah. But
whichever way, we're always going to be in the ministry, whether we're married to a man or in ministry or whatever, which way he leads you, God's hand was on Pamela. Mm-hmm. His hand was on you for the things that he has for you to do. And that was a season in your life. And now there's new seasons to just blossom, you know, because you planted good seeds. You know, you probably didn't see all that was going on that God was preparing you for. But look at it. Now you can put it down in print and just be a help to so many others.
Amen. Go ahead. Mm-hmm. Praise God. And I would be amiss, as they say, to leave my new husband, Robert Briley, out of the equation.
Okay.
Just him being such a support, mm-hmm. An encouragement. Very patient man, a gentleman. You know, the chivalry is hard to find, but he's just what God needed me to have at this season in my life. And I'm just very grateful to have him. You know him personally.
Yeah,
right. So you know who he is.
Right. I'm just waiting on my little part to be able to say, as his pastor's wife, as his spiritual mom, I should say, yeah. I am overwhelmed that God gave him someone like yourself. Okay. I see the glow on his face. I see the contentment. I just see he's in love and he's happy. And that's what I'm really, and because he has so much to give, he is so talented himself and he's so gifted. And mm-hmm. and for you both to come together with your gifts and your talents, it just blesses me more than you can even know, because before you were here, you know, I was believing for him to meet someone mm-hmm. just like yourself, and, you know, not knowing, like you said, you don't know what you're really needing, what God has for mm-hmm. you, but you're just, you know, but I knew it. And like I said, not just a smile on his face. I just know, even for the time that you guys have been together, it's just God sent. So it was it's a prayer answered for me and Pastor, because we've known him for years. So thank you for being that good thing for Robert.
Thanks, God.
Amen. Amen.
Go ahead. Yeah, I did want to touch on this. You mentioned just being able to juggle all of those things mm-hmm. as a wife, you know, as a mother and business owner and different things, an author, all of that while still trying to manage the home and working full time out of this is before COVID, you know, working, going to a job, you know.
Right.
And all of that. But I just, it's nothing, but it was just God's grace. You know, Amen. That's all. There's nothing I can do or say that would change that. It was just nothing but the grace of God. Mm-hmm. And how do I know that? Because of the ease in which mm-hmm. I was able to do it. Wow. I couldn't have done it without the Lord and just the knowledge and understanding, okay, these are the steps to take. This is the timing. This is when you do it. This is how you do it. That's mm-hmm. all God. You know, the scripture tells us it tells us to cast our cares upon him, for he cares for us. But he also tells us to basically include him in our plans and that he will establish our thoughts.
Right.
So, concerning that thing. You know, before, a lot of times what we'll do is we will start something and then ask God to bless it instead of first including him in and say, mm-hmm. okay, God, establish my thoughts concerning it. So we part before the horse in a lot of instances. But that has been another thing that I've recently learned that, okay, that's what I was doing, but not knowing that that's what I was doing by inviting the Lord in to the projects, you know, and just trying to be led by him. And as far as the timing, that's so important.
I just love the way how you acknowledging him in that area, because that is so important for women. Overall, women have a lot that is over us. There's a lot of responsibility God has given us, like yeah. right in the beginning of the scriptures where it says that he was making woman to be the helpmeet to the man, you know, and so if we're here to help them, that means we got to have a little something extra to be able to not only take help, do what we have to do, but help them as well. But God trusted us with us, and he handcrafted us and made us special to be able to do it. And so I know that there's just so much God has in store for the for women who, that's why I believe God put that on my heart to do the women's business, so that, and because I'm a Christian, I'm a woman of God, you know, we got to recognize it's him that will give you the ease. He said, come unto me, all ye that labor are heavy laden, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Learn of me, you know, for I'm meek and holy. And, you know, and so, and you'll find rest for your soul. So when, and he says, acknowledge me in all your ways and I will direct your path. And I can hear that all through what you're sharing with me, that you know, you acknowledged him. And then he was able to just like, I don't even know how I do it as I'm just sliding through it. And, you know, and I look back and I said, how did I do that? How did I, you know, go to work, get up early in the morning, you know, take the children to the babysitters, you know, go to work, work the hour, come home, go to the grocery store, go, you know, fix the food. Do all that and, you know, still maintain certain different things, you know, do the ministry, having Bible studies, having this and this and that. When you look back, it's like, I don't know how I did it, but God did
it. That's right.
And, to him be the glory. And if we need it in him, then we're going to continually need him as we move, because I still believe the best is yet to come.
Absolutely.
You know, we don't need to be looking back. We thank God for what he did, in, you know, in the past, but there's more. Can you believe, Dr. Pamela, there's even more? He wants to continually bless. So I'm just believing for your businesses and your books, your, you know, the writings and their teas. I mean, tell us a little bit about your teas.
Tierra Teas, it's a luxury herbal tea line. And again, just an idea, you know, we pray that the Lord give us concept ideas and different things, and that's what he will do if we trust him to do that. So he gave me the name Tierra Teas. And so the First in Flight business, as I said, it's a distributor of the teas, but but our market is really toward the hospitality industry. So for people who are putting on events, women's conferences, weddings, women's teas, things of that nature, tea houses, coffee shops, those are the people that we are marketing to. So, but it's a wonderful line of teas. We have only five flavors, but that's good because it makes it extra special. It is a luxury herbal tea line. Three of them are hot teas, and then we have two iced teas. Okay. And again, it's on First in Flight, or if you look up Tierra, T-E-A-A-I-R-A, and we put air because of breathe. Tierra. So if you look up Tierra on Facebook, you should be able to find it. It's a fairly new business and a fairly new product, but it's a really great, product. And I've always loved teas. Because, you know, what woman doesn't like to relax?
Yeah,
you know, and so with the Airbnb and the teas, it just, it's a perfect match. So
perfect.
We're excited about what God is going to do with that.
Amen.
Yeah.
We're thrilled to hear about it. And I got blessed with some, and I didn't, you know, how things kind of get, it's like it was an anniversary or something special was happening. I said, who gave me the tea?
Yes.
Now I can put the dots together and just be able to relax and just speak over that business and that it will continue to prosper. But thank you for sharing that with us.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Amen. So we're probably getting close to the end of our wonderful conversation, but what tip would you like to leave or pass on to the audience? I know you've given some great wisdom already, but what would you like to leave?
In terms of business, I've always been fond of the scripture that talks about that we should, whatever our hands find to do, do it with all your might. So to me, that is excellence. When we do things to the best of our ability, even the casting of the bread upon the waters, you know, we're just trusting the Lord to take it from there. We've done our best. We did all that we can do, and we just trust that the Lord will take it from there. So if you're in business, you know, if you're doing anything, whatever you do, I just think it's so important to try your best at it. You put your best hand to it and do it with excellence. So aside from having the Lord as your Lord and Savior, you know, that, of course, is the most important thing, the main thing.
Right.
But if you want to talk about business, that's what I would say.
Right. Well, you hit that business part, but I just want to close out and just let you know how much I admire you as a woman who withstood a very tough time in your life. And for women to be able to see that there is life after divorce, after, you know, betrayal or whatever. I don't know the whole incident with it, but to see that if you can keep your trust in God, no matter what has happened in your past, that there's a future that God has for you. And like you said, you know, it's like, I can continually move on, you know, God's hand was on my life and he's blessed you. And I don't know if you know how much and how beneficial that is going to be continually to the women that hear your story. I don't know how much of it is probably in some of your writings and some of your books, but whatever it is, in far as relationships, you can move on with Christ. You know, it. No man, no relationship can stop you from what God has for you. And you are just a beautiful display of the beauty that can come after the ashes, you know, after the hard time, and trusting in God, and then God giving you this great gift of Robert to continually finish the beautiful work that he has for you. And there's just so much more, and your daughters are so blessed. I don't know that I know them, but you're a beautiful woman to be able to have, to be able to look up to and say, my mom is a hero. She's a woman of God, and it's because she put her trust in God. Because that's the ministry. You know, it's not so much the title of this pastor's wife or anything like that. It's the woman who knows her God. She that, you know, she that fears the Lord. She's the one that shows forth his beauty. So we see that beauty in you. Very proud of you. So thankful.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I, too, admire you a lot. And like you said, I mean, you've been married for much longer than I have, but you understand the struggles and the challenges that come along with being a minister's wife and all that stuff, and just a wife in general, and being a mother and a, you know, all of that. So and you handle it with such grace. So I do admire you as well. And again, I just really thank you and appreciate you and Francine and everyone involved that have, you know, inviting me to be a part of this platform. It was a huge honor.
Amen.
So thank you.
So thank you, mighty woman of God. Continually be blessed. And we look forward to getting to know you better.
And likewise.
You that are watching, thank you for being a part of our conversation today. I pray that you have received something from this conversation to help you know that is nothing too hard for God. God is not through with you yet. He's got a plan for you, and it's a good plan. And his plan for you is great. So we love you. Thank you again. Thank you, Dr. Hannon. We see you all next time on Conversations with Dr. Brenda Goodell. Bye-bye.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to Dr. Brenda's YouTube channel to get notifications and to watch past conversations.